Hey everyone, Javert here for HitFilm. Today I'm going to be showing you how to transform your footage shot in the daytime into night. Now most of this tutorial is possible in both HitFilm Pro and Express, but some of the filters or effects may require additional add-ons. I'll tell you about those when we get to them though. For now, let's get started.
For this project, there are three things that I recommend you download. Number one is the actual project file, which includes the car footage and the 2017 project with all of the layers. Number two is a pack of light flare presets called Radiance 2.0, which you can download for free from my website at inscapedigital.com. And number three is a pack of 75 lens dirt textures called Bokeh, again, which is free and can be found at my website. You'll find links for all of these in the description. When you're turning a shot from day to night, one of the dead giveaways is the sky. At night, the sky should be black. So we're actually going to start by motion tracking this shot in Mocha in order to replace it. If you're using Express, you can find this add-on for $50 on the HitFilm store. I'll drop the Mocha HitFilm effect onto the layer. Go into the controls panel and select Launch Mocha UI. Skip to the end of the timeline here where the clouds are visible and select the X-Spline Layer tool. Draw a large tracking area and right-click to close it. Because there isn't a lot of detail in the clouds, come down to the track controls and increase the minimum percentage of pixels used. Now hit Track Backwards. Once that's done, come over here to the right and select Export Tracking Data. For the format, select HitFilm Transform Data. Click Save and place the file somewhere you can find it. Back in HitFilm, select Import Composite Shot and select the file you just made. It'll open up with a plane, which you can delete, and a point, which holds the tracking data. Cut and paste the point into your main composite shot. I'll rename it skytrak. I'm going to make the sky more interesting with this picture of clouds. I'll position it here in the shot, making sure it's big enough to not get cut off when the camera moves around. Then draw a rectangle mask and feather it near the horizon. Parent the layer to the skytrak and set the blend mode to overlay. Let's add the actual day for night effect onto the car footage. I'll decrease the horizon, and then under the near section, increase the brightness. Let's add a curves effect before the day for night, just to brighten up the shot a bit more. Then a levels histogram to bring back some of the contrast. This next curves effect is going to give the whole scene a blue tint. I'll do this by dropping the red channel way down. Then I'll lower the green just a bit and raise the blue channel. The night sky should also have a few stars, so let's add those in. I'll create a new plane and make it 2500 by 1580. Again, so that it doesn't get cut off at any point. Add the fractal noise effect to this layer. Under this first preset dropdown here, select Starfield. They're a bit big for this shot, so under Transform Scale, I'll lower that to 5. To decrease the amount of stars visible, come down to Appearance and lower the offset. Set the layer's blend mode to Add. If they look a bit too sharp, throw on a diffuse effect. Similar to the clouds picture, I'll draw a feathered rectangle mask at the bottom. I have a PNG of the moon, which I'll drop in, position, and resize until it looks good. Drop on a curves effect to lessen the contrast and tint it blue slightly. Let's add on a glow and set the blend to add. Raise the radius and lower the intensity so that there's still a bit of detail left on the surface. We're going to create some moonlight by dragging in the plane from the media panel and adding the fill color effect. I'll make it a pale light blue. And position the center on the moon. Select the ellipse mask tool. Hold down the Option key to make it grow from the center, and draw a shape around the moon. Come into the controls panel for the mask and increase the feather strength. I'll duplicate this moonlight layer and decrease the size of the mask to have one that is closer to the moon. Select both layers and set the blend mode to add. You might need to lower the opacity of one or both to dim the intensity. Now for the headlights, I used two templates from my own Radiance 2.0 pack. I'll go to Import Composite Shot. Select the project file and uncheck all but headlights and anamorphic blue. They'll import as separate composite shots, but I'll just cut both the flare and point layers and paste them into my main. Rename the layers as necessary so that it's easier to keep track of them. This next step involves tracking the headlights of the car. Axel has already made a tutorial on this, and you can watch it by clicking the card on screen. Even though it is from an earlier version of HitFilm, the techniques are the same. When you apply the tracking data to the points, be sure to select the one that corresponds to each headlight, left or right. The flares will automatically move to the correct location. The anamorphic blue flare is only attached to the left. I didn't make another one for the right. These headlights are a bit big, so I'll go into the anamorphic layer and delete the hotspot and glow effects. I also lowered the saturation for each. You can see that each flare is made up of many different parts. This gives you more control over the size of certain elements, and you can intensify or completely remove them if you want. Now we're going to add a grade on top of the whole thing. First up is Bleach Bypass, which is in the Film Looks pack for HitFilm Express for $25. If you find that it crushes the shadows too much, you can add a curves effect onto the original car footage to lessen the contrast. Next up is a vignette, which, depending on your shot, may make it too dark. To bring back some of the colors, I'll add a hue, saturation, and lightness effect. Under the master section, I'll raise the saturation and shift the hue slightly if needed. For my final shot, I used Lens Dirt 7 from the Bokeh pack. Drag it down into the timeline, resize it, and hide it by clicking the eye. Add the Lens Dirt effect to the grade. Then, under Dirt Layer, select that picture. Adjust the settings so that it's more of a subtle effect, and only appears when the headlights are directly in the frame. Remember to turn on motion blur for layers if your shot is moving around.
I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Let me know if you have any questions below. I've got more videos like this coming over the next few weeks, so be sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.